What is going on, everybody, and welcome back once again. My name is Jordan, also known as Jane Monster, and you're watching episode 5 of our Wood Elf campaign. Something very strange is happening here. Apparently, this Bretonian nation here, who is the enemy of one of our newfound allies in the last episode, wants to become our vassal and give us all their amber. So you know what? Why the hell not? Sure. I've never had a vassal in these campaigns before, literally ever, so I'm kind of happy about that. Looks like the Waterfall Palace, everyone's real happy over there.
Lady of Athel Lauren.
I think I'm missing something here. There should be horses, yes. What you do? Okay, yeah, get in there. Get into the Oak of Ages. That's what I want you to do. So we have a branch right there, which I got earlier and I have done absolutely nothing with. Wild Riders with Shields. Can't really do that right now. We'll need to make an Asari Forge over here. Or yes, that's what we'll need to do. A Vintner's Barrel. I guess we might as well, and maybe we'll start adding a few more warriors to Askira's force here so that we can use him in the field at some point.
You need me?
Oh crap. I didn't mean to do that. I didn't want to do that.
This said to you. We got
Reynard the Maréchal. Oh, Reynard the Marshal. What do you want? Oh, okay. We do have like a treaty with these guys that allows us to just trespass whenever we want to. Perfect. Okay. That's what they're gonna do. Well, they're your problem now. Enjoy. I've done my part. Let's see here. Definitely gonna have to make an Asari Forge because I want to make some horsemen from this area. I'll be coming up pretty quick here. What we can do for now? Tol Tirin, who are you? No cost mystifying. Oh, this is our branch wraith. Call of the Woods, +8 melee attack. I think that affects everybody. Oh, no, no, that's not for the entire battlefield. 30 meters though. That's pretty decent. No cost mystifying miasma. That's kind of useful for slowing down cavalry. Maybe we'll pick that up. Awakening of the Wood. Oh, and you get Earthblood too? Perfect. I like the branch wraith. That's awesome. And we'll pass the turn there. Yeah, I think it's going to slow down a little bit. You want a defensive alliance. Who are you at war with? Carcassonne. Aquitaine. Sure, but I'm gonna break that if it's convenient for me to do so, I guess. Let's see. Yeah, we control quite the empire here, but I think it's gonna slow down a little bit now that we've beaten back Morgur and his Beastmen savages. Oops, sorry about that, guys. Let's see. I don't want just a regular Glade Guard. I want to try and invest. I want to get Starfire Shafts, but I'm not entirely sure how I go about doing that. I think I have to upgrade this. No, I have to make a Bow Forge, so that'll be the next thing that we do at level 5, which is apparently going to cost me 2 amber. Okay, fine, I'll do it, just because I like the Waterfall Palace. Because it's the only place that we can build upgraded archers from at this point. Holy crap! Oh my god! Well, yeah, sure, let's be best friends. Give me all your amber. You don't need it, do you? Anmir is attacking Kinel's attack. You're giving me 1 amber, and you're giving me 1 amber, but you have some really expensive property that I like, and that'll help us like kill the boredom in the meantime. So you know what? Okay. Wait. Yes, this is the one we want. Okay, so we're gonna enter into the fight on the side of our buddies there. Carcassonne, sure. Don't ask to be my vassal. I don't really want too many humans as my vassal. I just did it because I thought it was funny. Let's see here. Let's take Durthu. Oh, that's gonna be a fight. All right. Let's move Askira and his forces. Wait, can I get you into the other province just walking normally? Yes, I can. Okay. That is good. They'll probably sue for peace. What I really want to do is draw them out of there. Maybe they'll go in a tactile round if they don't know that I'm here. Not enough movement points to go into ambush dance, unfortunately. Oh hey, they're gonna do it anyway. I like that. Defensive alliance, sure, let's be buds. Fine. Not aggression pack. Just leave me alone. Plus 12 leadership. Minus 50 recruitment costs for dryads. Well, we're gonna be doing that pretty quick here, so I suppose we might as well. Can we? No, we won't make it all the way. What we could do. Let's go right here and maybe try and set up an ambush. I don't know if that will work or not. Yeah, we're not going to have enough movement points, but maybe we can do it on the next turn if they decide they want to commit to attacking Talleyrand. We can take that back pretty easily, I think. What do I want to do? What do I want to do with you? This is always useful. There we go. More money! I'm not going to spend anything on Talleyrand right now. That might just end up being a waste of funds. Yes! More Treekin. Let's see. Dryads. But you're so bad! No, we'll just get another Treekin. That's fine. Some more archers. 4 units of Treekin. I like it. Alright, pass turn. Yeah, no, I'm not researching any technology. I don't have any technology to research, alas. Anmir wants to be friends. Nope. Holy crap. Okay, so we are going to be able to wipe them out here, possibly in a turn or two. So I will see you guys on the battlefield. All right, here we are. And who recognizes this map? I mean, I love Total War Warhammer, don't get me wrong, but there is a serious, serious paucity of maps in this. It's kind of gross. I don't really want to fight my whole campaign on like 3 different maps. Okay, so we're gonna move these guys up. I don't unfortunately have the troops for an oblique formation. Oh, they have their own Treekin too, and that's kind of fun. Not that it really matters. There's so few of them that we'll just be able to run right through them. Naturally, we have some Vanguard deployed troops up here. Oh, that's fun. Thanks for doing that, game. Nothing big was happening, but okay. Alright. Let's move them up into position here. Let's see who they're going to fire at. Whoever they start shooting first, I'm going to drop Flesh to Stone on them just so we can get ourselves into position and not take too many casualties. Alrighty, so that's who they're shooting. Go, Eternal Guard Shields, enjoy, boys. Oh, look at this. Love it! I love it so much. Destroy them all! You know, I think it might have something to do with the projectiles in this that they could be causing it, because it's only the Wood Elves, and that's like the main thing that distinguishes them. Okay, move ourselves forward here. Get our Treekin into position. Let's do it, boys. What happens if I do this? Bad things happen. Got it. Where's Duthu? Let's have him smack down these elven Treekin imposters. Move a little bit faster. Nice little bit of health for these guys as they go in. Give our archers some missile power. Oh man, this is gonna be a brutal fight. What are we doing over here? Those are Wild Riders. Did not see that coming, but that's okay, because they are not gonna win that fight. Not even close. Let's focus down Glade Riders with you guys. Let's do this. Take down their Glade Guard. We need to focus on their ranged units right now. Destroy those Glade Riders in a couple of shots. Let's try running it normally. Oh yeah, look at that. Watch them die. Oh, that's so obnoxious. I think what we might do in the future is maybe we'll start just turning off the sound. Because most of it comes from the sound. I mean, there is sometimes a frame rate drop, but yeah, we'll fix that. We'll find a way around it. So we can have something approaching a normal campaign. Yeah, wreck those Glade Guard. Oh god, they're not in a good spot. Let's charge them forward. This poor unit here is getting hammered by like their entire line. Die. This is what a real forest spirit can do. Come on, Durthu. There you go. Boom. Bet that felt nice. Let's see, these are Waywatchers. That would explain why they're able to stand up to so much punishment. Let's take these Glade Guard down. They're a little bit more of a threat right now with their numbers. Let's try to turn that on. Oh, I love it. Look at him die. Nope. Okay, no, we won't do that. Yeah, their Glade Guard here are just getting butchered. And that's 90% of their force, so we can take them down quickly and efficiently. And that cripples their range component. Alright, Durthu. Where are those Waywatchers? Let's find them. Right here. Looks like their army's gonna start to crumble here. We've broken through their front line. There's routing troops. Yeah, and it's a mass rout. Enjoy! We did take some pretty significant casualties though, so I don't know if we'll be able to easily take out the garrison, so we'll have to just starve them out. 150. How did our range units do? I feel like that's where most of the killing was done. Yeah, our Eternal Guard didn't do too much, although I think one of these units was the one that was engaged against the Wild Riders. But yeah, for the most part, that was our archers. Good job, guys. Give yourselves a pat on the back. Yes, I will replenish my captives. Sure. I'm gonna break it, though, if I have to. I'm not committed to you guys at all. Let's see. I like that weapon strength. Crank that. Dial that up to 11. Oh, wow. What do they got here? It's a pretty big force. We're going to starve them out, though. We have no reason to rush ourselves into a siege at all. Let's see. Weight Watchers. No, all these guys cost amber. What I want. Plus 40. And now, I think we have lots of amber. Why don't we do that? Hurry that along just a wee bit.
Lady of the Glade, at your service.
What are we doing here? Looks like we didn't really need all these troops to begin with. That's okay, though. I'm going to keep them up here to guard our northern borders. I'm going to station them at the Glade of Eternal Moonlight. Seems like a good idea. What do you guys want? Yes, definitely buff that up. Get our economy back on the right track, because we were down to just 514 per turn. That's unacceptable. I'm not going to fight the Wood Elves for you guys, no. I mean, we could. That could be a... No, let's think about this for a moment. Okay, we've destroyed Anmere. There's only a few Elven factions left. We could potentially take the entirety of Athaloran. For the sake of our Bretonian vassals. Let's see. How much do they give me? No. The Wood Elves give us like 6 amber. That's just not worth it. Not worth it at all. Especially when they surround the Oak of Ages. Things can go release. Pear shape very quickly. Knowledge of the Ancestors. That's kind of nice, I guess. Well, that's Hecate. That's the Wood Elves scream that in combat all the time. They're all like, Hecate Onutha! I'd like to know what that means. If there's a lexicon for... Oh my... Oh shit! Guys, I just declared war on them. I'm an idiot. Whatever. This is fun. This is gonna be interesting. Okay. garrison them down at the Feast Hall of the Wardens. Let's take care of Anmir. All right, let's fight this, and then we'll deal with the consequences of this later. Maybe we can convince the Wood Elves to be buddies with us again. Oh my God, I can't believe I did that. But you know what? We gotta play it where it lays. We have to deal with the consequences of this. Did I not just tell you? Right, that's what I wanted to do. Okay, so I'll see you guys on the campaign. All right, this one we want to get over with quickly. Oh, it's a beautiful map, by the way. I don't think we've ever played on here before. But yeah, we want to get this over quickly, so we're just going to go with our standard kind of triple line formation. Dirthu in the front to soak up all the archer damage as he goes in. Attack! Yeah, seems like a good position. We'll just be able to fire directly into the woods and directly into their troops from there. That must be the garrison. You must protect Athaloran. You guys are standing in the way of progress. I am Athaloran. God, I love the treekin. So damned nice. Ugh. Oh, that's so irritating. Keep things going at a good pace here. Okay, so I'm gonna slow that down. Break our archers off from the group. You guys can be group two. Stick you right out here so you can just rain death upon our enemies. We're gonna move in with our infantry and such. I know they've got a couple tree men in here, which is a little bit disconcerting. There's one right there and the other one's probably hiding somewheres. But yeah, we'll find them, we'll destroy them. We have lots of Eternal Guard. Yeah, could probably use another unit. Maybe we'll get rid of one of our basic lady guards. Probably a good idea. I hope this isn't bloodier than it needs to be, because now we have to fight the Wood Elves, although maybe we'll be able to smooth that over in a turn. If not, if I can't reach some kind of diplomatic agreement here to fix my screw-up, I guess we'll have to fight them. That could be interesting. Oh, you guys can't hurt Dirthu. Do you know who I am? Glaive Infantry. Oh, those are anti-large. You probably want to keep Dirthu away from them, if at all possible. He'll be able to soak up so much of that damage, though. Let's speed it up just a wee bit. There we go. Treeman in here against those Glaive infantry. I know that's a tough fight for Dirthu, but we're gonna let him do it anyways. Not everybody is within range to fire, so maybe what we'll do is we'll move these troops around here. I like that. I like that as an idea. Let's take our Eternal Guard, get them into this fight right now. Charge! For Athaloran! This would be a really confusing battle. Everyone's screaming, "For Athaloran!" I wouldn't want to be involved. Let's actually break these guys off. We'll put them right around here. Time for... There we go. Give Dirthu some extra armor. Oh, guess we didn't drop the heal. That's alright. There we go. Give it to Dirthu and those treekin. They're gonna need it. There we go. Be able to drive those treekin into the ground. Let's move our waywatchers up here onto the hill. It's probably not a bad idea. Let's try running it in normal motion. Nope, that's not going very well. So let's speed it up just a tad. Boom! Pummeling those treekin as we go in. Alright, kill those glade riders. That's what you're here for. Oh, look at them melt. Love it. Really need to get those deep wood scouts in the back. They're quite lightly armored. Able to do lots of damage to them. Alright, got a nice shot here on those glade riders. Oh my God, look at the melt. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. Take a look at the battle here. Dirthu just doing work. Good job, bud. Make me proud. Blow up these Deepwood Scouts. Hey, guys. Catch. Boom. Let's slow down here. Enjoy a little bit of glorious slow motion. Our Eternal Guard getting pinned down here against what looks like... Oh yeah, we found the Tree Man, but we're able to do quite a lot of damage to him. Looks like he's fighting our Treekin, which is preferable to him fighting the Eternal Guard. It means the Eternal Guard can do their work without fear of too many casualties. Oh wow, we wrecked them. Alright. Time to press our advantage here. Let's move into this little clearing here behind their lines. Outflank them and surround them. How's Gligard not having a good time at all? There we go. Things looking pretty grim here for these treekin. I think we are winning. They're probably losing decisively. Yeah, they can't fight elves on their own. This Eternal Guard here just getting worked. Oh, goodbye! Dirthy managing to hold up pretty well here. Sword of anti-heroes. Yeah, we're gonna get him the Sword of Daith at some point. I believe we just got the quest for it to destroy a whole bunch of armies, so we're well on our way at this point. Those Deepwood Scouts here. Yeah, maybe we should just throw these guys into the melee fight and we'll let our archers do work. I'm kind of okay with that. Quick volley into these guys. One, two. Make me proud. What magic? There we go. Get out. Get out of my woods. Uh-oh, they've noticed us. Yeah, it's gonna be the end of these guys. Let's watch that happen. Oh, apocalypse. I had them hit that tree, man. Probably a good idea. Wood elves here, just cleaning up. And that's the end of them right there. All right. Nothing left to run down there, as they are a garrison, will destroy them all. I love that his name is Catra, and I don't even think I saw him in that fight. But I'm pretty sure Catra was one of the original Gundam Wing pilots, so that kind of makes me happy. Yeah, we did alright. Dirthu just did so much work. I'm pretty sure he outkilled the entire army. Rip Catra. Rest in pepperonis, my friend. Yeah, we're gonna seed it. Alright, province secured, and Mirror's mine. That's gonna be a huge boost to my economy. Looks like we're on our way to... Oh yeah, we got this. We'll be able to get the Sword of Daith in the next episode. If you guys are curious a little bit about where that comes from, actually, I believe it is the Cromlech of Kedai, Torgavan. Pretty sure it's them. There is a very ancient smith who lives in what I'm fairly certain is this area, who has been in the woods since the original elven colonists, because Athalorien is this weird place out of time, a lot like Lothlorien in a lot of ways. It's, yeah, time does not pass normally here, so that it's entirely possible that a colonist has been alive for thousands upon thousands of years since the beginning of Azrai history, and he is a blind smith, and he forged the Sword of Daith for Dirthu, which he uses to smite the enemies of the forest and occasionally smite the elves themselves, but we won't talk about that. Let's see here. Yep, definitely do that. Okay, let's make the wood elves like us again. We probably still have a huge bonus with them, or maybe we don't. Okay, they really don't like us. Peace treaty. Alright. Oh, that was so dumb. Okay, we'll have to work our way up to getting back up to 11 Amber again so that we can upgrade the Oak of Ages in the next couple episodes. Oh, that was so dumb. I feel so stupid. Yeah, that really didn't need to happen. Oh, well, we've managed to preserve our relationship with our vassal, which I kind of like. It's too funny that that's actually a thing. Yeah, that's fine. I'm just going to pass the turn here. Join war against... I don't want to attack Mordrin. I got enough on my plate right now. Go to hell. Alright. Any character to the following region. Walls, Anvil. Any character. Does that include agents? I wonder. Let's see what we can recruit in this area. Just about anything we want. Good. Okay, let's get rid of one of our basically guard units. Probably the one with one chevron is the wisest choice. Let's get ourselves... Oh, that's fine. We'll just move Dirthu over to here. Boom. Perfect. What else I want to do with you? Finish that off. More violent delights. Dirthu is becoming such a monster right now. He basically just tanked that entire elven army and all of their arrow fire for the entire battle. All of the war dancers. I want to upgrade you, or do I want to upgrade... Let's do that. I guess we... No, you don't need any more Treekin. Probably use another one of them. And then we'll figure out what we want to fill the rest of his army out with later. That'll do. We'll do one more turn. We'll see what happens. Ah, lovely. Hey, let's be friends. Defender, Carcassonne, Aggressor, Torgavan. Yeah, I don't care about you. Oh, crap. Your ally has been... Wait, hold on. Would I be entering the war on the side of Torgavan? My ally has been attacked. No, it's them who's being attacked, so let's decline and break the alliance. That's what I wanted to do. See, that's what happened before. I thought, you know, by clicking the button underneath the faction who's being attacked, that it would enter me into the battle against that faction, which made sense in my mind at the time. Let's see here. No, I don't need to do that, because war dancers, even basic ones, cost amber. That's pretty much all, I guess, that we can do for this episode. I'm going to try and keep it a little bit shorter. A little more easier to watch for you guys. I try, but it doesn't always work out that way. Some of these battles take forever. Alright, so that's the end of episode 5. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I will see you in our 4th Age campaign in just a little while. So take care, everybody. Bye-bye!